Hi dear friends, welcome to the channel AKY Biotech. So as you all know, in the previous videos we have discussed many of the questions which are asked in the examination. Today also we'll be discussing similar questions with the brief explanation. Hope you have liked the previous videos. If you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel and please do see the previous videos also. They are interlinked to these videos and they are very helpful from the examination point of view. So today, without wasting any time, we'll move on to the video and please subscribe the channel. And if you have any doubt, do comment in the comment box. So moving on to the questions. Number one, the first X-ray diffraction pattern of DNA were taken in 1938 by, you have the four options out of this. The correct option is this one, number A, that is William Asbury. The first X-ray diffraction pattern of DNA of low quality taken in 1983 by William Asbury. He used DNA supplied by Ola Hemmerston and Torbjørn Caspersen. Next question. In early 1950s, high quality X-ray diffraction photographs of DNA suggesting the DNA being double helix and composed of two nucleotide strands. Who took these photographs? Correct answer is this one, number D, that is Rosalind Franklin and Maurice Wilkins. So the X-ray diffraction photographs, they were taken by Rosalind Franklin and Maurice Wilkins. It suggested that after these photographs, the conclusion was that it was suggested DNA structure was helical and might be composed of more than one nucleotide strand in early 1950s. Moving on to the next question. In 1952, an ambiguous established work in the laboratory of Alexander Todd led to the discovery of, answer, correct answer is this one, option C, 3-2-5- phosphodiester linkage regularly links the nucleotides of DNA. So here comes the explanation for it. This is chemical nature of DNA. This was discovered by Watson and Crick in 1952. They also found that nucleic acid strands are held together by hydrogen bonds. Again, the first X-ray diffraction structure was discovered by William Asbury in 1938. Next question, number four. What should be the complementary strand of 3-ATGGCTTGA5-? So here are the options. First of all, moving on to the explanation of it, and then we'll choose the correct option. So the complementary of A is T, we know, and for G, that is C. Therefore, the complementary sequence should be TA. So for A, it will be T, here A, then C, okay, then G, A, then C, then T. So here is the option, okay. Then, and the two strands are anti-parallel, we know. As the given strand is 3-2-5- direction. So the complementary strands should be 5-3- direction. So we are left with two options, that is B and D. And out of this, you know, this one is the correct option, B. Next, if in a double-stranded DNA molecule, we have adenosine, that is A is equal to 30%, we need to find out other three, that is T, G and C content individually. So this question has been asked many times in ARS as well as ICR JRF in 2001 and NET 2015. So the correct option is, this one is the correct option, A part. So moving on to the explanation. So as it is given that A is equal to 30%, as we all know that A is equal to T. So if A is equal to T, the other one also needs to be 30%. So here is the correct option, T is equal to 30%. Then what we are left with, G and C. Now we have to calculate the other two. So for the other two, we need to subtract this one, because this will be 30 and this will be 30, that equals to 60. Now 100 minus 60, that is equal to 40. So if G is equal to C, then equally it will be divided. So 40 divided by 2, that will be 20%. So answer is, this one is the correct option. Now question number 6, in a DNA double helix, the bases are held together by hydrogen bonds. These hydrogen bonds are non-covalent bonds. Hydrogen bond is weak non-covalent bond. This occurs between two molecules, resulting from an electrostatic attraction between a proton and an electronegative atom of other molecule. So no share of electron takes place, which is the criteria of non-covalent bonding. Here no share of electrons, and this is the non-covalent bonding. Number 7, it is easy to break the bond between A and T than in between G and C. So the correct option is true. How come? See, why it is easy to break the bond between A and T as than compared to between G and C? This is because A and T, as we all know, it is held together by a double bond, whereas G and C, that has the triple bond connecting them. Thus, the energy required to break a double bond is lower than it is required to break a triple bond. Hence, it's easy to break this one, A and T, the bond between A and T. Number 8, with respect to the importance of hydrogen bonding and DNA double helix stability, which of the following statement is false? You have to choose the false statement. First of all, I would suggest that before attempting any question, you just take what is being asked in the question, whether the correct options. Sometimes in a hurry up, we go just for the taking the correct options. So they have asked about what is false. So the correct answer is, decreases the entropy. When the two complementary strands of DNA comes together in an aqueous solution, the water molecules attached to the polynucleotide strands are displaced from the bases. This creates disorder and this increases the entropy. Therefore, it finally increases the stability of DNA duplex. So the false option is that it decreases the entropy. Next, in the late 1970s, non-double helical form of DNA was also suggested but was discarded on the basis of certain factors. Which of the following is not a factor responsible? The correct option is nuclein. Nuclein, later named as nucleic acid, and eventually DNA was first discovered by Swiss physiological chemist Friedrich Mascher inside the nuclei of human WBC in 1869. Thus, nucleon is not a term related to the structural orientation and chemical nature of DNA. So here comes the 10th question, that is the last question. This scientist Levine investigated and found that nucleic acid is composed of polynucleotides and each nucleotide is composed of one base, a sugar molecule and a phosphate. This was performed on the genome of, correct option is yeast. What this scientist did, Levine placed his initial proposal of nucleic acids being composed of nucleotides and nucleotides being composed of one of the four bases, a phosphate and a sugar molecule in 1919. He gathered all his evidence regarding the structure were from the repeated experiments of hydrolysis and analysis of the yeast nucleic acid. So the correct option is D, that is yeast.